which has gained so much popularity that I think everybody's covered it, from the local kind of leader newspaper all the way through to, we thought we'd made it when the ABC Compass did an episode. We went, wow. And only last week, a couple of days ago, we were featured in the New York Times. I guess an initiative which is founded on principles of social justice, which is re-engaging a community and our humanity. And this is simply an expression of the local, certainly started at a small local level. But when we speak of justice, and I think please humour me and enable me to continuously and tirelessly repeat the need for recognition of Indigenous peoples. Sorry, let's let these people in, just so we don't have to repeat ourselves. Hi, welcome, come in.
Okay, thank you.
I think you rarely get asked Muslim or non-Muslim at your entrance. So Muslim or non-Muslim, guys? okay, one more, come on, let's go. Yep, excellent. Yellow, another Muslim, come in. Find a spot. Okay, we'll start again. So firstly, recognition, any platform of social justice has to be founded on the recognition of not only its historical kind of context, but also some of the issues and tensions impacting us today. For unless we tell the truth, we cannot progress in a meaningful way. And our truth is such not to make us feel guilty, but rather to enable us to feel empowered and genuinely take responsibility for being benefactors of the continued dispossession of Indigenous people. Now, sadly, discrimination doesn't discriminate. And if we're engaging with one another and trying to humanise one another's experiences, then all these issues impact all of us. They are our concern, they are our business. The dispossession of Indigenous people, no matter how marginalised we are, it is had on the back of being beneficiaries of that. Now, it is 2017, sadly, and we are still tussling in the background with basic recognition for a treaty that we don't have in this country. This is not to shame us, this is simply to recognise and feel empowered by making these truths our business. So for me, platforms, however small, of social justice have to be founded on, and I think it was Mandela who said, you can reconcile any issues and atrocities provided you begin to tell the truth. And this is our way of taking a little bit of responsibility for our benefiting from those issues of dispossession. So I'll just add two more things, because I think it's important to keep that conversation alive until such a time as we tip into the mainstream conversation about justice. So it's not just about Muslims, it's not just about Indigenous people, it's not just about, it is about all those groups that we marginalise, yeah? So a couple of facts that came to mind around the issues impacting some of the Indigenous people is that where there used to be 300 languages and now we're left with barely 100. Who knew that? One.